on police action on 22nd March.
It's coming, yeah.
The police action on 22nd March 2016. On that day, I was in an interview boat. Let me say first on police action, then if time permits, I'll take 2 or 3 minutes what happened exactly. 22nd March, I was in an interview boat that was going on in Central for Human Rights. There was a selection for DEOs. I was sitting along with colleagues and it went on up to 1:30. After completion of interview, then we went for lunch. It was 2 o'clock. And while coming back, we came to know that Upper Rao came onto the campus. Because I stay outside, I really do not know whether Upper Rao came or not. But while coming from lunch in the guest house, I came to know that Upper Rao came. And then students are protesting at Vice Chancellor's Lodge. So after coming from the guest house, and we stopped at the School of Social Science. Some of the colleagues, myself and Professor Lakshmanarayanan and Dr. Thirumal, we gathered there. And then we head towards VC's lodge. It was around 3 o'clock afternoon. Then we went directly inside the VC's guest house. Inside the guest house, there is a huge lamp. The students were raising slogans, sitting on the lamp grass. They were raising slogans. Some of the faculty were standing very nearby them. By the time police arrived, they were also surrounded by the students. They were there in front of this. They were raising slogans, and the police were protecting the VC's gate, that one door, and they were standing there. So we are watching that, and it went on for some time. Then I listened, police had some announcement. And one police fellow called me that, no, he was a student of human rights course that's going on in our university, distance education. He said, he said to me that this is a residential, private resident, one cannot do like this. I said that to him, this is not a private residence, and it is official residence where he's conducting and where he's staying. So I think there is an argument about whether it's a private or public, and I can't take it now. Time permits, you can do. But I saw the students who are raising slogans and singing songs against the operation that was on campus, earlier clampdown of by the police on the campus. Then we were sitting, some of the faculty, and just, you know, watching. Our students should not get anything. So one announcement they made, and after that, you know, police started beating and dragging, what Mr. Soni said. We saw in front, I saw them, the students were dragged out, and then they were kicked and then brutally assaulted by the police. And especially women students were beaten up, I saw them. And I also saw some of the faculty peeping through windows inside the VC's house. And I felt very bad. In front of us, some of the faculty were standing, and police, you know, must us not to go there towards the students. We were stopped. I was seeing the students, and then I'm seeing some of the faculty inside, how the students were beaten up. We were not allowed to go to the students. And after when they were chased out, they very forcefully vacated that place. And after that, we were in the process, we were also asked to go out from there. So we said, we are going out, but don't take the students. So I came out, and they also asked me to go very far, but up to the humanities building. So I came to the humanities building and started calling some of the colleagues, and we were there. There I saw the students who are running for life, because the way police attacked the student, I think the past 16 years I stayed on the campus, I never saw that kind of incident. Even 2002, anecdote I'm not going to give, but I never saw police brutality on the campus. Either in JNU, I stayed 10 years there, on campus of HCU, because they were helter-skelter, running here and there, buses, but police were, you know, chasing them as if they are criminals. And I saw them, I came to know that Dr. Tathagat was also taken. Then I again went inside the VC's guest house. I saw Tathagat's shirt was torn, and he lost his chappal. He was badly, you know, was in a bad shape. I saw his shirt was totally torn. Then I asked the security fellow, why you are taking the faculty? He's a faculty, he's a faculty in the department of mathematics, and I know him. Then the response was, if he's a faculty, why is he with the students? Now we said, we are not with students, we are just, you know, we are there standing. And how can you take? He argued. Then they pushed me up to the humanities building. They were almost, you know, chasing me up to the humanities building. I was there along some faculty. Then there I resisted. Resisted in the sense, I am asking the police not to beat our students, I said. Repeatedly I was saying that not to beat our students. I said, who are you? They tried to ask my name. I said, I am a department of political science. I am head of the center for Ambedkar. They said, why do you want my name? They are asking my name. I didn't say my name, but they are asking me, you should not object us. But you are, the way you are treating my students or our students is not correct, I said. Then they didn't listen to me. I said, I am not, you know, entering into the students group or the ABET or ASSFI or ABET. I am asking them, when our university students are beaten up by the outside forces, that is the police, then as a teacher I have an intervention. So that's why I am arguing with them, but they said, no, you can't stop us. They said, it's not a student's class here. You are one-sided, they don't have any arms. They are sitting, actually they were sitting on lawn. They were not having, I don't see that, whether they were having stones and that thing, student. So, but they are not listening, and they also pushed me. Then, when I was arguing with them not to beat them, they also forcefully pushed into the van. I think once they count, we are 18 members in the van, including me. By the time Tathagat was also taken in ambulance, that I saw, but Tathagat doesn't know I was taken by police. So they were taken in some other van. In the van, I was sitting the third row. 17 boys, I am the 18th one. I think it's a very, very brutal attack on the students. Personally, one boy caught, this I wanted to record because I saw that in my naked eyes. One boy caught by three policemen and beating them, kicking them and then abusing. They also abused me. The abuses are very, very intolerable, sir. Because they are saying, why do you want to kiss off love on campus? Why do you want to observe Guru's things? Why do you want to anti-nationals? We are going to book you on anti-nationals. Why you are teaching? Towards me they said, you are teaching anti-national lessons in a classroom? You are teaching lessons on observe Guru? You are teaching lessons on Pakistan? They are asking me. So I said, I don't know what to say, but when they are beating inside the van, I said not to beat. I saw one boy, he lost his specs while beating and he was trying to take those specs. And the policeman took those specs and then he tried to push, hit him his eyes. It was very inhuman, sir. I never saw, I think, what enmity that they had against the students. I felt so bad. I pleaded in a van also. Then I went, while pleading with the police, they also slapped me. And from the van started from Gopal food court till reaching, I think, to almost 1 kilometer away from police station, they started beating, abusing, all sorts of. Our mothers were abused, our sisters were abused, along with them, students, me and everyone. Or your mothers comes from Pakistan, or your sisters born to Pakistan, are you born to Pakistan? So why do you want to hear? With whose money you are staying on campus? I think we never heard this kind of thing. Who caught them? Why the policemen? I felt there is no law and order problem on the university. There is no such violence. What happened in the morning, I have not witnessed before. But after 3 o'clock, I was there around 5:30, 6 were picked up. Till reaching the police station, I think the way the boys were treated by the police were inhuman. I never saw. This is on a police action that I wanted to record. I think this is uncalled for. Mr. Appa Rao, he's a teacher. I know he's a teacher. He's not from Kashmir, military officer comes from Kashmir. He's not from any military area coming and taking over vice chancellorship. He's a teacher who stayed almost 25 years on the campus. and he claimed that they are all his students. They are seeing from the windows the students were dragged and kicked and the women students were abused. I think no teacher came out. Some of us are trying to prevent and we were taken as a student. They were asking our names. What are you? What is your name? Police asking our name. And perhaps I think just I wanted to share what Rohit's mother said. Exactly 3 days before Rohit's death. This is the unholy statement. If you give me time, 2-3 minutes, I wanted to say. Before 3 days of Rohit's death, Mr. Appurav called all the 5 students who were expelled. Their supervisors were called by Appurav. My student was there. Rohit's teacher was called, and Prashant's teacher was called. All the 5 teachers were called. There were some deans, heads were there, upper hours. And he was telling to me so many things. He was giving almost 45 minutes lecture without me for a lot. So he gave a lecture that the campus should be very calm. I am doing this. After listening 45 minutes of his lecture, I asked what I think. I really moved by a statement, sir. Sir, to be frank, I do not know whether my students was expelled or not till I was called. I asked Appurav after listening to him, sir, you are saying me too that to speak my student after expelling these many days. Had you called me before expulsion, had you at least informed me, I would have spoke to my student. What she said exactly? She was not informed whether your son has done this and that. I think this is, you are there to administer, not the rule, like the military rule on the campus. It's an academic thing. The way you are dealing with this campus, I think very atrocious. See, yes, I asked, you received 5 letters from the ministry. No single word whether students got fellowship or not in those 5 letters. 5 letters explicitly say that what happened to that incident? What happened to that incident? Minister who is heading human resources, whether those fellowships were given to them or not. No single word on fellowship. No single word on expulsion. What happened to that case? I think this is the attitude. I asked Appurav. Proctorial board, nothing is new. R.P. Sharma constituted and revoked it. And while revoking, he asked to re-enquire into the entire incident. But I asked Appurav, sir, where is the new enquiry? There is no enquiry. All that reproduced the first proctorial board, which is a biased. I said in front of him. And I requested by saying all these things, sir, I have a request to you. We 15 people are here, heads and supervisors, and you are. Kindly will visit Velivada. You come with us. We must visit Velivada. They lack confidence on the university. We must, I think, ensure that confidence. We should go to visit. We should go to the Velivada and talk to those people. I pleaded with him, along with my other colleagues also, they are there. I requested Professor Appurav to come and visit them. He blatantly refused to visit Velivada. It takes hardly, not even 5 minutes from administrative building to Sapkan. Had he had come on that day, I think Rohit would have some confidence that administration has something. I requested him, but he refused to come. Unfortunately, after 3 years, we lost Rohit, which I think he's a scholar. I think I can't say his word, but the way he put on 17th letter, I asked him. 1 month exactly, today also, I think tomorrow is the 17th. December 17th, he wrote a letter to Vice Chancellor. That's a very, very, where were you as a Vice Chancellor? What happened to you? He wrote a letter that you give us poison, ropes. That letter was not revealed to them. Where was Chief Warden? Where was the DSW? Why they didn't talk about it? Had they talked about, and these ministers and all the political clout, they are talking about what happened to that issue. What injustice that has been done, what is it, a caste discrimination, they never talked about it. And they were talking about the violence that happened. Now, calming the campuses, for whom, for what? I think there are many questions. They have different perspective on those things. am not here to perspective and methodology, but there are lot of things to say. But the way Mr. Apparam acted on that day, it's fresh in my mind. He refused to visit Veliwada. And the same Apparam refused to visit the dead body of Rohit. See, you are a teacher saying 25 years. What for you are teaching? What for you are? I am asking. And the people are beaten in front of you. And you are claiming that he is my student. He said that I am pained when the teachers are taken. And really, really you concerned about the pain. You should have visited Veliwada. You didn't visit. You don't have even sympathy to visit to a dead body of a Dalit boy. The way his body was consumed, I think he is a terrorist. And all our names, my name, Dr. Lakshminarayan sir, Professor Harugopal sir, just before 1 month, they declared our names as anti-national. They published their ABV pamphlet in the press, as it is, they published, declaring us as anti-nationals. I think this is a campuses on the university, I think really come to the entire educational process from, Radhakrishnan Commission from 1948 to Torat Committee. I would like to say, what happened to those commissions? How campuses are run and how they are administered? I think on the discrimination point, I have 2 points, I don't explain them. There is a 2 forms of discrimination on the campus, I would like to say. One is academic and administrative. Both are taking life of the students. Other issues. Why Rohit is a very, I think it's a peak of, I think. Why Karam Chedi has become a movement for Dalit? I think Rohit is a very, the way he wrote, the way he put philosophically, I don't think so MHRD minister and Mr. Apparam would understand that language. I don't think so they understand. The language that he used, I think that is the substantial change of Dalit students' mind on the campus. That mind you are, that mind made you to intolerant. That intellectual improvement for that you are intolerant. And that intolerant was exhibited by Apparam and Lisa. Till now, he is not able to come to the campus directly. Because if you claim that you are a teacher of the university, you should come and talk to them. I saw the Vice Chancellors, Professor Ramakrishna Ramaswamy. We asked him to come in, despite his problem. We asked him to come to the tent where the Dalit students pitch the tent. He sat almost 1.5 hours in the tent. I was told Ramarao, who expelled 10 Dalit students, was also there at base. He sat with the students. As a vice chancellor, you are not able to come to the students. For whose students? You students are there with you. For them, you are a student, a vice chancellor. I think I am not here to pose many questions. I think this is what the universities, I think we must really come to them. I'm thankful. I think we need to have a justice to what Rohit stood for. I'm saying we were in a police station, we were treated properly. In a prison, we were treated properly. There I felt, I think prisons are better. What in human rights course I think we are teaching and prisons are decent. I felt when we were in a prison, when their food was cut, when their ATMs were cut, when their electricity was removed in the hostels, I think we were getting food by 6 o'clock evening, by 6 o'clock morning we were getting breakfast, whereas our students were not getting in the hostel on HSU campus. We salute to the civil society who came with a lot of packets and other humane attributes. I think we must salute them the way they responded, civil society. As a vice chancellor, you could not even do that. I think this is a very, very, I don't know how to put it. I think we need to understand this one. I stop here. If you have any question, I would like to respond.
I would like to repeat a question I asked the first student who made a presentation. As just to, based on your experiences, his experiences, what you broadly suggest the appropriate remedies to overcome this particular university with this particular kind of episode that has taken place. I ask this because everything is negative around politically, legally, so whatever you call it, and the voice is, you know, small. There are limitations. But given the situation, we can't run, you can't run away. So what do you suggest concretely, in concrete ways, would be one, two solutions?
I do this chart demand and the civil society demand that in a road that act must be made to deal with the discrimination. That's the one thing, cost discrimination on the campus. But apart from that, second suggestion that I would like to insert, I think the way university administration is run is a problematic. If universities are not, or universities are intolerant to the dissent, it was a decent protest on that day. What I saw is, it was a very decent, very democratic protest. And if you don't have to face the decency of the students' protest, first of all, you have to understand what is the dissent that they have, university student. You cannot say they are politicized. And you don't have the mechanism to understand that dissent that comes from the students. Since they are not understanding the dissent, and they don't have any mechanism to resolve it. So the understanding of that dissent is more important. What I could see is, for the past almost two decades that I spent almost on campus, I think there is a changes, structural changes on universities that have to be dealt properly. And what I don't have any ready-made mechanism, maybe through discussion we can evolve. But I am for democratic dissent on the campus. You cannot outrightly say that campuses are for normalcy. It is not a natural science lab. University cannot be a natural science lab. Where you do in a chemical mixing and doing and sitting in a chair and seeing the chemical reaction. That's not possible. And the teachers, that reaction, if we do on the streets, they are saying, why do you want to give lecture on the streets? Street is my lab. As a social science student, I have to listen to that dissent. But if the universities are not able to, if they feel that universities are ruling for the students, I think that idea itself is a detrimental for the development of democratic education in this country. One should not have that one. So that I am seeing for, I think, the series of incidents that are going on in our country, the administrative posts that are held by the so-called, they are saying that students should not have a politics. Then why do you want to have a politics of a vice chancellor? You are coming with a politics, and you are asking the students not to have a politics. I think that is ideological debate that we need to have. And I can't have any authority to take away their ideological affiliation. And when you are coming with an ideological affiliation, you don't have any moral right to ask others also to have. So I think central universities, I think the motive of establishment of central universities are different. At least central university must be guarded from this way. The democratic dissent must be allowed, and it must be flourished. I'm not saying with violence. I think who is for violence? I think they're all evident for the past, ever since they were expelled in August, then ever since they established Reliwada, they have not resorted to violence. They have not resorted to violence. On 22nd March also, they have not resorted to violence. I'm warning, I don't know what happened, but they're saying someone is thrown and someone is stoned, other things happen. But I am not witness to that, I can't comment on this. As far as my thing, I think students have never resorted to violence. Now, why do you want to maintain normalcy on the campus? On pretext of maintaining normalcy, the deployment of police, we outrightly condemn. campuses cannot be the campuses of polices. See, they are asking me to wear the dress to enter into the classroom. After classroom, they are asking me to wear police dress. The students, the teachers are asked to be like that. I think they are not. You need to have a discipline, but not regimentation. You need to have some kind of thing, but not this kind of violence on the campuses by the police forces.
Dravas University as a whole, and this incident, what do you think? The majority is with you?
I'm sorry, I'm not.
You know, the student, you know, university campus, yeah. Entire university, students, teachers, and staff.
Yeah.
Out of these, are the majority, is the majority with you to support you? Or you are, you think, you feel you are in minority?
But, I think on, sorry sir.
No, that may not be a...
No, I wanted to say sir.
No, why am I...
Majority doesn't decide the justness.
No, no, no. No. I accept that, but my, counter queries or the questions
is
that...
Justice in one place, no. Justice everywhere. That's
right, there, yeah. But then efforts to win over the others' faith and the sympathy to get you supported. That's very important.
Yeah, I must salute to the students of Central University. On 12th April, they had a UCBM. On that 12th, I believe.
Yes,
12th. And 950 students unanimously passed over the exam. So that shows the strength of the students. I think they are for justice. They are for Rohit justice. We are for it. There is some problem among the teachers. Maybe there are some teachers. Of course. And they were asked in a JNU. Yeah, when myself and Dr. Prabhakar, we went to JNU, they said that 95% of the teachers are with the students. And whereas 5% of the teachers on campuses in HSU are with the students, still I believe it's a good that 5% are with us. We are going to win. 90% of the students are with them. I think there are teachers who are, I think, this dictatorial attitudes of administration may be making them, but somewhere there is some soft corner toward the justice. With that belief we are going forward. I think, if not the teachers, I think entire civil society is with us.
Yes.
That's how I think HSU is making. I think I appreciate the students' courage, the way they faced on that 22nd March police. So really appreciable. So still we are in a winning position.
She want to make
if
a point.
I can make one point regarding the
take
question.
Take the mic.
Just adding to Ratnam sir, I just want to mention one point that University General Body meeting is the highest decision making body of students. So yes, the quorum was established and was attended by 949 students, and there were five resolutions passed, to which one of the resolutions, of course the main resolution, is Appa Rao Purile should not stay in this campus anymore. There was one opposition from the other side. So 948 members passed the resolution. And so, from now on, it is not the decision of just 949 members. It is the official students' mandate of University of
Iowa. Okay.